Okay, let us discuss problem number 10.46. So what this problem says, so this is 10.46. So this says, predict the major product including a stereochemistry. So this time stereochemistry is also important. When cis-3-methylcyclohexanol react with the following. So cis-3-methylcyclohexanol. So you have, so let me so show you the structure. So cis-3-methylcyclohexanol. So you can use OH here. This is H, 1, 2, 3. So cis, so OH and CH3 both are in cis position. Same molecule can be shown something like this if you want. Let us say, so OH here as a something like this. And here you have CH3 that is also on the solid line. The same molecule can be shown something like this. Repeating. Now let us follow this step. So if I follow this formula, what kind of product we will get? So here I have OH and here I have CH3. Now if this compound is reacted with, first is PBr3, what will be the product in this case? Now you know what will be the product. So in this case OH will be converted to Br. Now see, in this case Br minus attacks and O goes. Now this reaction goes with inversion of configuration. You see, we have said in the class, first it forms a complex and Br minus attacks from the back. So this phosphorus takes oxygen and from the back side Br minus attacks. So this reaction goes with inversion of configuration. So in this case inversion takes place. Inversion. So if you follow the inversion, you will have OH. Now Br will, that is attached, will go downside because initially it is upside. CH3 remain as it is. So this is the A part. Now B part, please keep copying fast. Here we have OH. Here you have CH3. Now if this is react with SOCl2. Now again, as in the presence of SOCl2, I can, OH can be removed and Cl I can add. But you have to remember, in the presence of SOCl2, reaction goes with retention. So this is a retention of configuration. So in this case, you will have retention. So you will have simply, it will remain as it is. So you will have Cl here and CH3 is here. 1, 2, 3, of course, CH3 is here. It will remain as it is. Now this reaction goes with retention of configuration. Let us discuss C. So this time this reacts with, so here you have OH, here you have CH3. Now this compound reacts with HCl ZnCl2. This reagent is also called Lucas reagent. Basically in question, this is this reacting with Lucas reagent. So this reagent is called Lucas reagent. So you have to remember the name. ZnCl2 plus HCl is called Lucas reagent. Now in this case, a mechanism is carbocation formation. And once the carbocation is formed, basically Cl- can either attack from top or it can also attack from bottom. So in case, you will get both product. So CH3 and Cl can be either same side or it can be opposite side. So in this case you will get cis as well as trans. So CH3 here you will have, and let me write here Cl. Now CH3 and Cl can be same side or it can also be opposite side. So you will get cis as well as trans, both product you will get in this case. Because carbocation is intermediate, once the carbocation is formed, now Cl- is free to attack either from top side or it can also attack from the bottom side. If attack from the same side in which it's the CH3, in that case we'll get the cis product. If it attacks from the bottom side, you will get trans product. So let us discuss next. So you have D part. If this reacts with HBr, so let us take the next phase. So you have D. Once again, this is easy one. Everybody can answer. So here you have OH, and here you have CH3. Now if this react with HBr, give me the product. Once again, you will have a carbocation, so you will add Br here, and CH3 gets attached this side. So you will have cis plus trans both, and you will get, because carbocation is intermediate, so Cl Br minus can either attack from this face or it can also attack from the bottom face. So we'll get both product. Now let us say E1. So you have this initial compound is cis, so OH and CH3 both are cis sides. Now if this compound react with TSCl pyridine and then NaBr. So first is TSCl in the presence of pyridine, and the second is NaBr. So now this is SN2. First, what will happen? Pyridine will take H plus, and minus O minus will attack on TSCl. Cl will go, so it will form OTS. Are you getting? And then in the next step, Br minus will attack from the bottom side. So it's the inversion of configuration. So in this case, you will have inversion. Are you getting? So you will have here, that is the reverse. So you will have Br, that is from the back side, and here you will have CH3. Same. If you're not getting, we can show the mechanism for this reaction, easy one. So let us discuss the mechanism. So here you have OH, and here you have CH3. If you react with pyridine is a base basically. So it will take H plus, you will have O minus, here you will have O minus, and here you have CH3. In this reaction, there is no change of configuration. Now this O minus will react with TSCl, so this has a lone pair. So this attacks here, this goes. So I think you are able to understand, please do fast. So you will have here OTS, are you getting, and here you have CH3. Now in the next case, Br minus can attack. Now the Br minus will follow SN2 path, that is it will attack from the back side. So OTS minus will go and Br minus will attack from the back side, because in this case both are the same side. So if you see, it can be shown something like this. CH3 is here and OTS is here, hydrogen is here, hydrogen is here. So Br minus basically will attack from this side. Are you getting? So Br minus will attack from here, and this will goes from here. So you will have CH3 Br basically anti to each other. So you can write something like this. So you will have Br is downside and CH3 is upside, so anti. So the product is basically, in this case, you will get trans product. Are you getting or not? So please copy fast, and then we'll discuss the next problem. Easy problems, basically reactions of alcohol, including the stereochemistry in some cases. So you have to remember when we will have retention and when we will have inversion of configurations. If you are using SOCl2, you will have retention of configuration. If you are using ZnCl2HCl, in that case carbocation is formed, so you will have cis as well as trans, that is attack from top, from bottom both. You have PBr3, in that case SN2 mechanism, attack will happen from the bottom side. Now if you use TSCl and pyridine, again SN2 kind of mechanism, attack will happen from the back side. So you will get the trans product in those cases. So let us copy this one, and then we'll discuss the next problem. So you can basically cover these lectures in the daytime also. You can sometime you can leave your school and copy these things. Try to understand all these things. If you are going every time a school, if you have a 80% attendance in the class, you cannot cover all these materials. So there is a lot of material we have on the video. You can cover all these material only if you leave some classes and come in the day and just listen all these videos, then only you can cover. If you think that you can cover by going to school, it is impossible because I have so many videos. Okay, let us discuss the next problem.